सूखा चिकन, Hi, I'm Jyotsna and welcome to Sanjeev Kapoor's Khazana. Today I'm going to show you Sukha chicken, which we have named Amma's chicken because we had this Amma who was a cook from Andhra Pradesh and she had perfected this recipe totally. And this recipe is her original recipe. It's not an Andhra recipe or something. It's a home recipe and I think you all will love it. The ingredients for this recipe are as follows. Some chicken cut into medium sized pieces, onions, ginger, garlic, whole red chilies, cinnamon, peppercorns, cloves, cumin seeds, coriander seeds, salt to taste, capsicum, some coriander leaves for garnishing and oil. Now let's make sukha chicken. This dish is very easy to make since we only have to make the marinade. So let's start by making our marinade. In a pan, let's take some peppercorns, cloves, coriander seeds, cumin seeds, whole red chilies, and a small piece of cinnamon. We just need to dry roast it a little bit and then all this will go into our marinade. Our dry masalas have been roasted. So now let's make our marinade. In a grinder, we'll take some onions. You can chop them into large pieces. Some garlic, little bit of ginger. And now we'll add these dry roasted masalas. We can add powders of these masalas, but I think the whole masalas give a very nice taste to the chicken. Our marinade ingredients have been put. We'll add some salt. We'll grind it into a fine paste. Just see if the mixture is not becoming very fine. You can add a little bit of water. Our marinade is now ready. A fine paste of all the masalas and onions and ginger and garlic. I can already smell all the flavors. Let's take our chicken in a large bowl. It's been washed and cut into medium-sized pieces. We'll poke it with a fork so that the marinade seeps into the chicken. We'll put the marinade into the chicken cubes. You can adjust the seasoning once we start cooking the chicken. All the masalas have gone into the chicken. It's ready to be kept in the refrigerator for 2 to 3 hours for marination. Now our chicken has been marinated for 2 to 3 hours and it's ready to be cooked. Let's heat a pan. Now it's very easy. We don't need to do much. All our ingredients are into the chicken. We have to take oil. And all we need to do is heat the oil and add the chicken which has been marinated. The chicken goes into the pan. You can even do boneless chicken if you're doing it for a party and you can serve it as a snack or a starter. You can make small cubes of boneless chicken, use the same masala and serve it as a starter. This dish can be eaten with rotis. It's a dry dish. It can even be eaten with bread, which we normally do at home. Now all we need to do is nicely cook the chicken. It will cook in its own juices and the marinade. We'll also adjust the seasoning, that is the salt. What you can do is saute it a little bit, then cover it about 5 to 10 minutes. In the meanwhile, you can do something else. I'll prepare the capsicum. This capsicum is mostly for the garnishing. We'll cut it into small cubes and add it in the end once the chicken has been cooked. This is a good idea even when you're serving the chicken as a starter. Our chicken is now almost done. Let's check it out. It has to be a little brown and crispy. Let's check if it's cooked. Yeah, I think it's done. Last minute garnishing, capsicum. Give it a nice color and a nice flavor too. Give it a nice stir. Our chicken is now ready to be served. The green capsicum looks really nice with the brown chicken and it gives a nice flavor. Some coriander leaves and a yummy, tasty Amma's chicken for you to eat.